Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to render table data in hierarchy structure using DataGrid component. The hierarchy data grid is used to display table data in a hierarchical structure, which can be shown or hidden by clicking the expand or collapse button. This feature can be achieved by defining the detail template in a data grid. If you want to know how to use the detail template feature of the data grid component, check the video linked to the above card or in the description below. I open an existing example where a grid is bound to the employee data. Wondering how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add Syncfusion grid component to it, check my previous video linked to the above card or in the description below. Now, let me run this example and show you the output. Check the grid, columns like employee ID, first name, title, city, and country are shown. In this example, I'm going to show you three-level hierarchical structure, namely employee data, orders data, customers data. In the next hierarchy, I'll show you order details based on the employee ID. So I add grid templates and detail template tags. Then I store the context parameter in the employee variable to access employee data model. Here, I create an order model class with fields like employee ID, order ID, customer ID, freight, ship name, and ship city with appropriate data types. I add SF grid tag and the t-value property. I set this order model data to the t-value property. I'm going to use the SF data manager to access the remote data. So I add the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Data and add SF data manager tag. And specify the services link for orders data in the URL property and set the cross-domain property value to true. Then I define the columns using the grid columns tag. I define the grid column tag with a field mapped to order ID and header text as order ID. I define the text align as right and width property as 110. In the same way, I define the column for freight, ship name, and ship city. Now I need to get the orders detail based on the employee ID. So I define the query property in the grid tag and assign the getEmployeesQuery method. Inside the @code directive, I define the getEmployeesQuery method and fetch the data using query based on the employee ID. I also enable the allowPaging property, which I have already explained in my DataGrid Getting Started video. Here, I add GridPageSettings tag and set the PageSize property value to display 8 rows per page. As you can see, in the DataGrid, the detailed row is rendered, and on expanding the row detail, it shows its corresponding orders based on the employee ID. In the same way, I construct the customer hierarchy based on the customer ID column from the order data model. I define the customer details model class with fields like customer ID, contact detail, address, and country with appropriate data types. Then to show customer details, I add grid templates and detail template tag with context parameter as orders based on the model class order. I add SF grid tag with a t-value property value as customer details. Then I add query property and assign the getOrderQuery method. In this method, I fetch the data using a query based on the customer ID. Now I use SF data manager to access remote data and specify the service link for the customer data in the URL property along with the cross-domain property value set to true. At last, I specify the grid columns like customer ID, contact title, address, and country. See the data grid. When I expand the employee row data, the appropriate order data is displayed. On further expanding of the order data, customer data will be displayed based on the customer ID. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.